Hello there, everybody, and welcome back to Prim ASMR. Today I have a variety of different video games from different consoles. Some are from the Wii. I have a couple PS4 games, a couple GameCube games, and then I have one from the Xbox One. So just a little quick preview of what we're going to be looking at today. I know a ton of you like these little show-and-tell game videos, so I rounded up another pile of games that were around the house that I hadn't shown you guys yet, so I really hope you enjoy this. I still look forward to doing a game store roleplay of some sort. I have some really good ideas for one, and a lot of props that will be very useful to make tingly sounds and stuff. So, I'm gonna go ahead and set these aside, and we're gonna go ahead and just look at them one by one. Okay, go ahead and get started on that. So, this is Super Mario Bros. Wii, and this is up to a 4-player game. Hold it kind of close so you can see the cover. A lot of people in my house are big Mario fans, so we have a lot of Mario games, as you've probably seen if you've watched my other game show and tell videos. Tons and tons of Mario stuff, Mario games. So, this says, Mario leaps into an all-new adventure. Scramble through courses with up to 4 players at the same time. Run, stop, and fly through 8 worlds packed with enemies and surprises. Then there's some pictures on the back of what the game looks like. Okay, I'll hold that closer in case you're watching. If you're not watching, you're just simply laying back and enjoying the tingles. Enjoying the sounds. Hopefully the tingles. Enjoying the relaxation. Trying to add a little bit more tapping sounds for you guys. Some gentle tapping. Also for the Wii, and this is an M&M's game. Go ahead and trace that. M and M's. This is kart racing. So this is a racing game, which if you've been following me for a while, if you watch my other gaming videos, you know that I'm a big fan of racing games. Okay. So this is really good game. It says, fasten your seatbelts for the new exciting new action racing game, M&M's Kart Racing. M&M's Kart Racing breathes new life into the arcade racing by combining adventure elements and high-speed racing with a funny and parodic style of candy competition. Compete against other players on 10 different racetracks and collect unique bonus items on every level. That's cool. Let's see how many players this is. I believe it's 2. It's not saying for sure. Let me see. Oh, yes. I believe it's a 2-player game. I could be wrong though. I don't see. This one is Kayla's Monster Buck Hunter. This says compatible with the Wii Zapper. And this is a 4-player game. Okay, it says arcade style hunting fun for the entire family. So, if you've had a Wii before, you know that you can get all these extra additives, I guess, these extra things that you can get to play different games with. You can get a little steering wheel, you can get little fake toy guns and stuff like this. So, that's really neat. This is a hunting game. I know several people that would love that. Love that. Now, this one is the Xbox One game, and this is the UFC 2. You can see Ronda Rousey here on the front. I honestly don't know who that dude is. I don't keep up with the UFC. I just watched WWE. And that's how I knew about Ronda Rousey. So this is a fighting game. And let's see. This is a 1-2 player game on Xbox One. 1-2 player game on Xbox Live. So, yeah. A mode for every fight fan. And there's just a couple pictures in the back. Not too many pictures, just a couple. So we've got that one. We've got a couple GameCube games to look at. Okay. This one is called Reckless. The Yakuza Missions. It's kind of reminds me in a way of like a Grand Theft Auto type of game, just because of the fire. Explosive, you know, environment. All the pictures in the back. Okay, so, you know, doing different missions, doing different law-breaking strategies, things like that. Is Tony Hawk's American Wasteland. I loved this game. I think I was in maybe 4th or 5th, maybe 5th grade, 5th or 6th grade. This is a skateboarding game, and it's really fun. I haven't played this in a very long time, but I still have memories of just playing it for, you know, my brothers, and that's a long time for me because usually I don't like to sit and play a game for a long, long time. But this one was really fun to do. Just so you know, especially when you learn how to do different tricks and stuff on your skateboard. I don't know what it was, but I liked it. Now this is a 1-player game, 2-player game alternating, 2-player simultaneous, and let's see. This is the first free-roaming Tony Hawk game. Skate LA is one massive streaming world. So, good to go around Hollywood, you know? It's really cool. Really, really neat. And that is for the GameCube. I'm not sure if they have this for other systems or not. Never looked into it. Always had it on the GameCube. Let's see. We have this one and then a few more. Okay. So we have this one. This is W13. And this is for the Wii. Is it a steampunk? It has to be. Yeah, it's steampunk. My youngest brother is the biggest steampunk fan. He is so excited that he's coming back, supposedly. You know? He's really excited. It says Live the Red. WWE Universe. Your actions shape your universe with dynamic matches, storyline twists, and unpredictable moments from the creative direction of the mastermind Paul Heyman. Oh, biggest WWE roster ever. Choose from nearly 100 superstars, legends, and divas from today and from the Attitude Era. So cool. Got the Undertaker there in a picture, pinning down. Who is it? King. 15, I think. And then you got John Cena, and who's that right back? Yeah. Pretty cool. See, this was made in 2006. I'm trying to see. Okay, so this is a 4-player game. Gold Edition. Enhance your gameplay with PSVR. I've never tried that. I've never tried one of those VR eye things with a video game. I got one year for Christmas, and I tried it a couple times, but I never really used it after that. But I bet that would be pretty cool to use for video games. So this is a 1-player game. Trying to find the year on this. Usually it says somewhere in the back. Let's see. Yes, it's 2017, so this is a pretty newer game. About almost 3 years ago. 2 years ago right now, though. Let's see. Fear Comes Home. Resident Evil Returns is the most innovative, immersive, and visceral experience yet. Explore unimaginable horrors to uncover the mysteries behind the abandoned Baker estate. So there's some pictures at the back if you're watching. Okay. Some pictures of what the game looks like. Thanks. I know it's kind of blurry. You can't really see that well. Sorry about that. But you know, just overall. PS4 game, and this is Legacy Edition, Call of Duty, Infinite Warfare. And then as a little slash here, it says Call of Duty Modern Warfare Remastered Campaign, plus 10 MP maps. So. It says the ultimate entertainment package, Call of Duty Infinite Warfare, Campaign, Multiplayer, and Zombies, and then Call of Duty Modern Warfare Remastered comes with Campaign and Multiplayer. This is a 1-2 player game. Let's see, and so the year on this is 2016. You guys have been following me for quite a little bit. You guys have heard before that I've said that I like Call of Duty Blackout mode. I think they've changed it up a little bit, but I played a lot of it last summer. Maybe it was last winter. Yeah, I played that a lot with my youngest brother. We had a good time. Okay, this is The Sims 3, and this is the Wii. I used to play The Sims for a long time. Like I said, I've never really been much for sitting down and playing one game for a long time. But The Sims was definitely an exception. I believe I was in... What was it? I think it was 6th grade. The summer of 6th grade, maybe. I played The Sims so much. It was one of the coolest summers. I'll just say that. One of the coolest summers. It just was like relaxing all the time, just playing Sims, you know. I haven't played The Sims in a long time. But I'm sure I could get back into it real quick. So my favorite Sims game is probably Sims Pets for the GameCube. That's the one that I played all summer. I don't know why, but I loved it so much. It's just kind of like addicting, which, you know, it's kind of bad. But I don't know, it was a fun time. So. That is all the games for today. I hope you enjoyed this little quick show and tell. Just some games I had laying around. I will talk to you all very soon, okay? If you have any questions for me about the games I showed today, I'll try to answer them in the comments. But yeah, so talk to you guys very, very soon. Okay, have a relaxing.